Oh my goodness! If you know, you know. Hello! My name is Shereen Ninzi. If this is your first video of mine, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm doing a highly requested video from you guys. You guys have kept asking me, what is your skincare? How have you cleared your acne? And I have been putting this video off for a really long time. So I'm gonna explain why I've been so hesitant to talk about my skincare, why I've been just so not wanting to do this video. To preface my acne, if you guys don't know, I have had acne, really severe acne, since 2017. 2016, it started to get really bad. 2017 is when it went full-blown, cystic, horrible, painful, on another level. The acne that I was experiencing then was caused, this is why I've been hesitant to talk about my skincare and acne, it was caused by a hormone. Let me say that again. My horrible acne was caused by a progesterone hormone that I was taking in hopes of clearing my acne. My progesterone levels are very low and I'm trying to figure out my hormones and everything like that. Thinking that my skin, my acne was caused by food I was eating. You know, there are things in your body that you shouldn't be eating or putting in, like dairy, over amounts of gluten, crap. You know, that's obviously gonna make your skin flare up. But at that point, I had been gluten-free and dairy-free for about 6 or 7 years, and I had not seen a difference in my skin because of my diet. In November of 2017, I was taking progesterone because my progesterone levels were so low, and that is what caused my flare-up. I ended up finding out that I have a rare genetic hormone disorder, and we're still trying to figure out. I haven't delved in it too much just because it's very overwhelming to me. But I have had to go to the hospital for it twice because of the amount of pain it puts me in. So we'll just put that out there. So these products may not work for you because you don't have a hormone disorder. Can you see why I've been hesitant to talk about it? So not only are my skincare products more geared towards someone who has hormonal acne, but I've also been on an antidepressant, and that is what cleared my acne. I'm gonna say that again. I found out my acne was not only hormone related, but also due to a high amount of stress that I was under. I've been on an antidepressant for 2 years now, and since being on an antidepressant, hopefully I can find pictures to show you the drastic difference it made in my skin. Being on the antidepressant literally cleared my skin in like 2 seconds. So not everybody can just go on and take an antidepressant. Like, that's not what I'm trying to promote at all, and that is not, if you need to take that, then do that. I needed it. But I'm just saying, it wasn't these skincare products alone that helped clear my acne. So that was my very large disclaimer. With that in mind, keep that in the back of your mind. These are the products that I've been testing for a long time, and I've changed my skincare routine so many times to kind of go with the flow of how my skin was working with my medication and that kind of stuff.
Editing, Shereen Ninzi here. So I also wanted to say that me opening up about being on an antidepressant and me opening up about being on my hormones, or like being on the hormone and having this hormone issue, is very personal and very difficult to talk about. So that's another reason why I hesitated to bring up my skincare and all that kind of stuff. I feel like I had to explain why I was having the acne issues I was having in order to explain why I was on the treatment path that I was on for clearing my skin.
I also found out that I have fungal acne. What is fungal acne, you asked? It's like a reaction to certain products in skincare or makeup. I'll put a more detailed description of what fungal acne is, but I'll zoom in so you guys can see what I'm talking about. Okay, so not only do I have spots, and that's another thing why I've been so hesitant to talk about my skincare, is because every time I want to come on camera, I end up experiencing a breakout, and I'm like, I can't film my skincare routine because my skin's not perfect. there's not going to be skincare that's going to clear your acne overnight or clear it to, you know, unless you go on Accutane or something like that. And that's not an option for me. So if you can see, I don't know if you can see really close, I have these tiny white dots. I don't know if you can see, like here. I get them super bad here around my temples here. I get them between my eyebrows. They're these tiny little white dots. They were supposedly, the dermatologist thought it was milia, but it's not. It's not, because they come out. Noticing what my skin was reacting to helped clear that up as well. So the first thing I'm going to start with is makeup remover. I use the Costco makeup wipes when I use makeup. So I use those, or I use a cleansing balm to remove my makeup. So Good Molecules actually has an instant cleansing balm. So this helps remove those really tough makeup products like eyeliner, waterproof mascara, liquid lipstick, stuff that just a makeup remover wipe will not quite get off. I really like using this because I use waterproof mascara, and a cleansing balm just helps that so much. So first thing you do is remove your makeup. Next thing that you do is you cleanse your skin. Ta-da! So I've been trying a lot of different cleansers. I've been literally benzoyl peroxide, everything. So for fungal acne, Skincare by Hyrum suggested the CeraVe Renewing SA cleanser, and that stands for salicylic acid. And the salicylic acid helps to exfoliate to get rid of those little bumps. This has been helping kind of combat my acne and help with the bumps a little bit. I still have them. I still am not 100% sure how to completely get rid of those, but it's gotten better. And I've been using this for a long time. This is actually my second bottle. And if you can pick this up, get it at Walmart. That's the cheapest that I found it. You can get it on Amazon. You can get it at Ulta, but I found that it's more expensive. It's about $14, $15. And at Walmart, I found it for $10. Don't know why that is, but if you can find this in person, definitely check this out. So I use this morning and night. Another cleanser that I use that is completely free of glycerin is Derma-E cleansers. So there's two of them, the hydrating cleanser, and then this is the anti-wrinkle cleanser. I couldn't find the hydrating cleanser. You can get this at Target, you can get this at Ulta, I think you can get this at Whole Foods as well. Obviously Amazon, places like that. But this is a vitamin A and glycolic acid cleanser. Glycolic acid is really good for fungal acne as well. Just doing some gentle exfoliation, not, you know, abrasive physical exfoliation like a scrub, but this does not have glycerin in it. And I use this when my skin feels dry. So I've been on Curology since 2015, and I've been hesitant to talk about it because it's been working so for my skin. It helps, and then I get to the point where I have to change my formula and do something else. So it's a good and a bad product. So Curology is really good. You can look up reviews. I know my friend Ivory has a whole video about her journey with Curology. So if you're interested, I'll leave her video linked down below. She has acne and oily skin. So if you guys are interested in any products for that type of skin, definitely check out her video. I'll use this at night if I'm going to be using my Curology at night, because Curology is a one time a day product. And then I just use moisturizer in the morning. I actually use the CeraVe Hydrating Moisturizer. I didn't bring that with me for some reason, but it literally just looks like this, just a moisturizer. So that's it for my everyday products. You know, you got your cleanser, your moisturizer, that kind of stuff. Something I also use every single day is an eye cream. I've used this Acure eye cream for a really long time as well. This is the Acure Radically Rejuvenating Eye Cream. It's just a really good eye cream. I've been using eye cream since high school. If you want to prevent them wrinkles, use eye cream. Now we're going to be going into treatment products. So like I said, on a daily basis, I use my Curology as my treatment, but I also incorporate masks and other skincare items as well. If I'm experiencing a big pustule or a breakout, I switch between hydrocolloid patches and a spot treatment. So the spot treatment I use is the Mario Badescu drying lotion. I've tried some other drying lotions from Amazon that are slightly cheaper, and the Mario Badescu one is just the best one that I've tried. You can get this on Amazon for a special deal sometimes, or again, use a coupon at Ulta. I use this at least every day if I have a large spot on my face that I need to just dry up. And then I also use acne patches. The ones that I've been purchasing over and over again are these from Amazon. These are a tea tree and hydrocolloid patch. Hydrocolloid is actually in blister bandages, so I actually used to buy blister band-aids and cut them up. It's the same thing. So hydrocolloid, what that does is it brings the infection to the surface. Sucks out all that crap. So you have a big cyst, pop one of these on. It looks like a sheet like this. So you just put these on. I put these on at night and also during the day. Since you have to wear masks now, nobody's gonna know. Nobody's gonna know. These aren't the best that I've tried, but they're still a good one to test out. Talk about this resurfacing retinol serum. I was using this for a really long time to help with my acne scarring. I need to start using this again. This is a CeraVe resurfacing retinol serum, like I said, and this is to help fade the appearance of the acne scarring. So when I was using it with my Curology, I would use my Curology during the day, and then I would use this at night. It helped my scarring a lot. It helped to even out my skin texture. Again, you can get this at the drugstore, CeraVe or CeraVe, I can't remember how you say it. Now let's move on to masks. One that I've recently discovered from Amazon again for fungal acne is the De La Cruz Acne Treatment. Maximum strength, 100% sulfur. So this is the mask here. It literally just looks like a clear, it looks yellow, but when you put it on, it just makes your face shiny. So you leave this on for 10 minutes. It's 100% sulfur, which is supposed to combat the fungal acne. So it penetrates the pores and dries and clears the pimples and blackheads. My skin is pretty dry after using this, so definitely make sure to heavily moisturize when you use this. But I've definitely noticed, again, it helping to break down my fungal acne little white spots. But this is also good for the cystic acne, again, to really dry up those suckers. I've got some masks that I use for resurfacing and my acne scarring. One of the ones from TikTok is the Ordinary AHA BHA Peeling Solution. This stuff is intense. If you have sensitive skin, or if you've never had a peel before, like going to the esthetician, your spa, or whatever, and getting a peel, this is literally a peel at home. This stuff burns, but wow, does it make your skin soft. I use this after I wash my face at least once or twice a month. I don't use this too often just because it is a painful experience. You leave this on for 10 minutes, and again, sloughs away all the dead skin, really helps with resurfacing the skin and getting rid of those scars. Something similar that Tula actually sent over, this is their probiotic and superfood brightening and resurfacing mask. This one is an enzyme mask that has superfruit enzymes and AHAs in it. It does have that tingling effect just like the Ordinary one, but it's not as painful. So I'll leave this link down below. I feel like this is a dupe. It's a little bit more expensive. The Ordinary one is on the cheaper side, but if you want something that's not as painful, the Tula mask is a good option. Another resurfacing mask that I was using is the Banish Pumpkin Enzyme Mask. I used this mask a lot when I had the huge painful cystic acne, like way back early 2018-2019. This really helped my huge red bumps, the painful ones that I got like down on my neck and everything. This really helped to dry those up and get rid of and prevent scarring. Because the amount of acne, you guys have seen what my skin looked like before, I'm surprised I don't have huge craters all over my face. The amount of acne that I had was unreal. I think everything that I'm gonna have linked down below, they are affiliate links. So if you do purchase through those links, it helps me, it helps the channel out a lot. So I appreciate it if you do purchase through those things. The biggest thing that I use is a facial cleansing tool. This looks a little dirty, looks like something else, but Clarisonic is no longer in existence. And I've been using a Clarisonic for years, but you can't buy replacement brush heads anymore. This is the PMD cleansing wand. It oscillates kind of and vibrates to really penetrate the product deep into the skin. And since this is a silicone type of product here, if you can see, it's got little nubbies all over it, it's not going to hold the bacteria. I really like using this. Again, it helps to exfoliate, really get the cleanser deep into the skin. I've just always preferred using a brush or some type of item to really get that cleanser in there real good. Again, it makes your skin really soft afterward. I just feel extra clean when I use a device like this. I think that's everything. Wow, this was a long video. Can you guys understand why I've been hesitant to make this video? I hope this helped. Again, my skin and acne is very specific to my body and situation that I'm dealing with. So keep that in mind, but these products are very good for other people besides me based on reviews that I've looked at. So thank you again for watching. Sorry this was so long-winded and me just blabbing on. But I hope you enjoyed, and again, if you purchase through those links, it helps a sister out a lot. Your girl is super broke. So thank you again for watching, and I hope you guys have an amazing day. Bye!